There is at least one, and perhaps as many as three, separate magmatic intrusions actively underway within a 60 square kilometer section of Iceland's Reykjanes peninsula. This means that one or more volcanic eruptions could occur at some point in the next 30 days. We know that a complex process involving magma is ongoing because varying amounts of uplift have been detected at three locations, a slower 1 centimeter a month uplift 1 kilometer southwest of Fagradalsfjall's 2021 vents, a rapid uplift at a site 1500 meters east of Festerafall, and, most worrying of these three, is a rapid amount of uplift centered 3 kilometers north-northwest of the town of Grindavik. Since the greatest amount of uplift in a day during the last week has occurred at a spot north-northwest of Grindavik, the alert level of that volcano, known as the Reykjanes volcanic system, was raised from green to yellow on October 28th. So, is all hell about to break loose with three separate simultaneous or near-simultaneous volcanic eruptions within a fairly small section of Iceland? To this, I say, not exactly. Although, if a volcanic eruption was to occur in the next month, it currently appears that the Reykjanes rather than the Fagradalsfjall volcano would be most likely to erupt. To best explain what is going on and how shallow magma might currently be in the crust, I will present the series of events which led to this unusual moment. A major earthquake storm began in the early morning hours on October 25th of 2023 on the Reykjanes Peninsula, leading to more than 1,000 earthquakes, including a magnitude 4.5 event. Then, over the next 24 hours, the earthquakes which were still occurring at a high rate slowly and progressively migrated 5 kilometers to the northeast. Then, whereas no high rates of ground deformation had been detected before, rapid uplift was suddenly detected at the southwestern section of the Fagradalsfjall volcanic system at a spot 1500 meters east of Festerafall. This uplift reached 1.5 centimeters in a 2-day time span, but ceased only after earthquakes subsequently migrated 5 kilometers to the southwest. Rapid ground deformation was then detected northwest of Torbjörn, totaling 1.3 centimeters uplift in 2 days. However, the rate of earthquakes has also dramatically decreased in the last 48 hours. Although we are currently unsure how many magmatic intrusions are ongoing or at what depth magma is located, I have created an opinion-based model to help explain what occurred throughout the last week. As a quick reminder, the majority of the entire Reykjanes Peninsula sits on one of 5 active volcanic systems which, rather than having a singular central vent, consist of many fissures that erupt at different points for each new eruption. For this graphic, we will focus on 4 of these systems. Between 2020 and 2023, the Iceland hotspot mantle plume tail, which largely feeds the region's eruptions, has led to the creation of 2 distinct magma chambers of 15 kilometers depth and 10 magmatic intrusions, of which only 3 reached the surface and erupted. My interpretation is that since late July, magma had been pooling, not intruding, at 10 kilometers depth underneath the section of the Fagradalsfjall volcano. The subsequent events are thus largely unrelated. Thus, the earthquake storm that began on October 25th initially represented the widening of cracks and faults in the crust due to a buildup of magma in the lower crust at the Reykjanes volcano. This magma then created a sill fracturing rock along the way and heading towards the east, going into Fagradalsfjall's deep magma chamber. The relevant magma subsequently shot upwards on the 26th until it ceased on the 27th when another sill intrusion occurred. Magma then shifted back to the Reykjanes complex at around 10 kilometers depth before sending a new body of magma upwards into the crust. As for the decreasing number of earthquakes, this could either represent that the intrusion is about to stall, solidify, and fail at depth, or it could mean that the top of the magmatic intrusion is already less than 3 kilometers depth where a nice seismic zone lies that produces few, if any, earthquakes. In my opinion, I believe the former to be the case, as the last 4 magmatic intrusions at the Reykjanes volcano failed, so something similar is probably the most likely outcome with an eruption not occurring. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.